You've seen us build the ultimate quiz engine in FlutterFlow, powered by AI and backed by Supabase and BuildShip. But a great quiz needs a great host. And in this video, we're bringing one to life with a bit of a twist. In part three of the Great Big Quiz of Everything, get ready to meet our AI quiz show host, who's basically the grumpy old man of artificial intelligence.
Boy.
We'll dive deep into generating his unique voice using services like ElevenLabs and integrating his playback seamlessly into our FlutterFlow UI. We're not just generating questions, we're giving our quiz a real personality.
But first, let's reacquaint ourselves with our app's design and data flow. We had the user kicking off a quiz with their own quiz topic on the front end, which is then passed off to our backend for processing in a service called BuildShip. This moves any processing tasks over to BuildShip's servers, meaning it's not happening on the user's device. This makes the whole process look slick and seamless from a user perspective. BuildShip calls OpenAI to research and generate our quiz, store the questions and multiple choice answers in Supabase, and send it back to FlutterFlow to move the user along to the quiz itself. Now you could, quite rightly, be asking, isn't FlutterFlow perfectly capable of making an API call to ElevenLabs and process an audio file? There are even libraries in FlutterFlow Marketplace that could help us. And the short answer is yes, we absolutely could perform this task on the front end. But we're going to have our backend perform this task. And the reason is that we always want to try and keep as much data processing or back and forth to external services and databases away from the front end as possible. It makes for a cleaner structure, is more secure, and since we're going to want to store our audio files when they come back from ElevenLabs to Supabase, and we've already set BuildShip up with write access to Supabase, it makes much more sense to leave this data-intensive process to the backend and incorporate it into the workflow we've set up in the previous video. But before we can do that, we need to go and make a new friend and pick out the AI host of our quiz show dreams. We'll find them in the ElevenLabs voice library. All right, here we are in ElevenLabs. First, let's head over to the voice library. You'll find it in the side menu. ElevenLabs offers a fantastic range of predefined voices. You can explore different collections, listen to samples, and find one that perfectly fits the vibe of your quiz. I'm looking for something engaging, maybe a little cheeky. The voice I've chosen is old Russo here, based on this dramatic TV ad read. I just know his part South African, part Australian, part New Zealand mashup of an accent, combined with some choice copywriting, will really bring the quiz to life. Once you've found your quiz host, or it's chosen you, add them to My Voices by clicking the button. And most importantly, grab that voice ID. We'll need this to tell BuildShip which voice to use. Copy that, and we're good to go. With our host's voice ID in hand, let's jump back into our BuildShip workflow. This is our existing workflow. It takes the topic, gets the quiz questions from OpenAI, and then updates Supabase. We're going to slot our audio generation right into this. Before the quiz begins, I want our host to announce the quiz topic back to the user in the form of get ready to play the great big quiz of whatever topic they've chosen. So we'll add an ElevenLabs text-to-speech node. And we can do this in parallel with the OpenAI node to cut down on a bit of time since they don't need the output of one another to run. We'll configure it with the voice ID we just copied. For the text, we'll dynamically construct it to say get ready to play the great big quiz of, and then we'll pass in our topic variable from the inputs. Keep the output format to something the audio player package that FlutterFlow users can process, like an MP3 file. And the rest of these settings come from the ElevenLabs UI, where you've listened to samples of the voice you've chosen. Once that audio is generated by ElevenLabs, it comes back as base64 data, So we'll need to store this somewhere accessible. We'll add a Supabase storage upload node. We'll configure this to upload to an audio bucket in Supabase. We'll give it a unique file path. I've chosen our UUID/topic.mp3. And for the base64 field, we'll pass in the base64 audio output from our ElevenLabs node. The upsert value will overwrite any existing file if true, and the cache control field sets how long browsers and CDNs should cache the uploaded file. Since this file is never really going to change, we're going to use this as the max age, which is the number of seconds in 1 year, meaning once someone downloads the file, the browser will use the existing file it has on hand for 1 year without even checking if there's a newer version. This node will then give us a public URL for the topic audio. Now for the questions. This is where things get a little more involved because we have multiple questions and we need to generate audio for each one. Looking at our current flow, we have the AI web search node outputting a JSON object which contains an array of questions. We need to process each question individually to generate audio. So inside the then branch of our conditional where audio is enabled, after the web search node, we're going to iterate through each question and we'll use a loop node for this. The loop node will take the questions array from the web search output as its input. Inside each loop, we'll follow the same process we used for the topic. For each question, we'll add another ElevenLabs text-to-speech node. This will use the same voice ID, but the text will be the question string from the current item in the loop. Then another Supabase storage upload node. This will also upload to our audio bucket. To make the file path unique for each question, we can use our UUID/question, the current loop's current ID plus one, .mp3. This uploads the audio for the current question and gives us the public URL. Okay, now we have URLs for the topic audio and for each question's audio. We just need to integrate these URLs into the JSON data that we send back to Supabase, actually update Supabase, and tell FlutterFlow that everything went smoothly. We'll modify our integrate audio files node, and we'll add in a new field to our JSON object. Let's call it topic audio and assign it the URL from our first Supabase upload. Then, as we loop over each question, we'll add each question object. The value for this will be the URL from the Supabase upload inside the loop corresponding to that specific question. So, the output of this node will now be a JSON object that looks something like this. This perfectly formatted JSON, now containing all our audio URLs, gets passed to our update row Supabase node, which saves it to the quiz session questions field in our quiz sessions table. Finally, our output node will return, verifying the quiz session ID and user ID back to FlutterFlow. Don't forget to ship changes in BuildShip to make this live. Our backend is now an audio generating powerhouse. With this complete, it means we've set everything up for FlutterFlow to bring our quiz to life. Firstly, let's add a little toggle for the user to tell us if they want to play with sound or not. This will reflect the value of a play with audio boolean app state variable. Next, let's handle the topic announcement. On our main menu page, head to the Play Now button and into the Action Flow editor. Scroll down to our new quiz API call to BuildShip. After this successfully returns, as in where our new quiz output is successful, we query Supabase to provide us with the full row of data for the quiz session ID that BuildShip sends back to us. Here we'll add a conditional action to check if the user is playing with sound, and if true, we'll add the play sound action. In our play sound node, under audio type, select network. For the network path, we'll set this from a variable. We'll pick out quiz session Supabase row. And because this is a query, it could have potentially brought back more than one item, we select item at index first, because we know there should only be one row with that unique quiz session ID returned from our query node. And select quiz session questions. Then select to data type. Because we have the structure of that JSON object set up as a custom data type in FlutterFlow, and the audio for the topic is saved as topic audio value. Before you leave the Action Flow editor, make sure you're sending that same Supabase row through to the quiz page as a page parameter, because we'll need it to play the audio for each question. And we can set that up now by navigating to the quiz page. When this page loads, it displays the next question, so we'll add in another play sound node at the same time. The audio file of our host reading out each individual question is stored together with the question text in the questions array. From this list, we get the item at index that matches the last question answered app state variable, which we're using to track progress. Finally, from that specific question item, we select the audio URL data structure. And just like that, our quiz now has a voice. Users will hear the topic announced and each question read out by our chosen AI host.
Welcome to the great big quiz of everything. You start the game by choosing the first topic, but don't get too comfy. After that, I'm taking over with four more rounds, each more tenuously linked to your initial choice. Think you know it all? Now's your chance to prove it. Let's get quizzical. Get ready to play the great big quiz of FlutterFlow. Which of the following is a key feature of FlutterFlow? Which programming language does FlutterFlow utilize for app development? What is the primary purpose of FlutterFlow? Which of the following is a key feature of FlutterFlow?
In the next video, we put the finishing touches on the great big quiz of everything, and I'll take you through the must-do steps for deployment. If you've liked this video, please like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.